Hello guys, and welcome back to the Pokemon Colosseum LP. This is part 3. And I just realized I never actually looked at Umbreon and Espeon to see what natures and stuff they have. And Umbreon has the Hasty nature, which, if I remember correctly, that's plus speed minus defense. And I don't like that, because Umbreon is meant to be a defensive Pokemon. So, and he's not meant to be fast. So, he kinda just got the backwards nature of what I would have preferred. So, whatever. And Espeon has Gentle. I don't know what that is. That's not a nature I've ever used. I might be wrong, but I think it's plus special defense, minus defense. That's a really odd nature, so that's why I'm not familiar with it, because no one ever uses something like that. And I can just tell based on it. Look, he only has 36 defense and 70 special defense. It's just a guess. I think that's what that nature does. But either way, I just wanted to look at them and show you guys that they have pretty much crappy natures. But anyway, after last time we were told to go somewhere. I don't remember where we were told, but I have to leave town. And there's three guys blocking the exits. And they all have a different Pokemon that I'm able to snag. And this guy, I think I told it earlier. The green guy had Bayleaf, the red guy had Quilava, and this blue guy has Croconaw. And obviously, knowing me, Aquablade, I'm gonna get a Croconaw. So, let's do this. And I'm gonna send my Espeon Umbreon, cause, yeah, and I have Makuhita. I'm only gonna use him as a last resort. Like, if someone faints and I need someone to replace him quickly, I'll use Makuhita, but I do not plan on keeping him in part of my team. Croconaw, on the other hand, I do. Now I'm going to use Umbreon to use Bite on Croconaw, because I don't think he'll be able to kill in one hit, and Espeon probably will kill a Grimer in one hit, so that's super effective. And I got a critical hit. I doubt I needed it, though. And remember, this is third generation, so he sends out a Pokemon immediately to replace Grimer. Which, I personally like the new generation ways of doing it, where it'll wait till the end of the turn to send out a new Pokemon, but that's just my preference. Oh my god, that hardly did anything! I guess that just proves how awesome Croconaw is. And you can use a Surf, and that's hardly gonna do anything to Umbreon, because if it... Yeah, Umbreon and Espeon have pretty good special defense each, so that's not gonna do much. Alright, Umbreon, you're super effective against Spoink, so you go for him. Espeon, I'll trust you not to kill Croconaw. If you do, I will be so pissed at you, you have no idea. Oh my god! I got a critical hit! That was scary. Espeon, you need to learn when you need to use these things and when you not need to use these things. That didn't make sense. I hope he kills Spoink by accident. Because, you know, wait! Oh crap, I forgot! They added... Yeah, Surf doesn't hurt your partner in this generation. Oh wow. And Spoink is a complete noob. In 4th and 5th gen, Surf hurts your partner. I forgot that in 3rd it doesn't. So you're going to finish off Spoink, and Espeon, during your turn, I'm going to use a Pokeball on Croaky. And Shadow Pokemon, I know you cannot give them a nickname until after they are no longer a Shadow Pokemon. And we haven't learned how to do that yet, so... yeah. Oh, crap. Maybe I should have bought some Great Balls. I should have known, because Croconaw is just a beast. He's not gonna let anything catch him easily. All right, gain experience. Yay! Can you use Bite? Oh crap! Oh my god! All right, let's try another Pokeball. I have 3 left, so 3 chances. And Espeon, I want you to use a Pokeball as well. I can't use it again right away? Then Espeon, you're gonna use Reflect. That's not fair, I can only use 1 Pokeball per turn. Come on, get in that ball, Croconaw. Get in that ball. Yes! Yay, I caught Croconaw. I defeated Bluno. Shredly and Folly can't be blamed for losing. Oh, those losers? Don't even get me started on them. Alright. What was that strange Pokemon? What do people do to it? That was Pokemon turned into a fighting machine by closing the door to its heart. What? You close the door to Pokemon's heart. I didn't realize there was a door to people's hearts, but okay. So what does that mean? I can't get inside its heart? I don't know how that's a bad thing. Oh, because they can't possibly love anything now. I get it. So it has to learn to love things again, and by doing that, it has to travel with me for a while. Now, let me tell you, I'll tell you one thing right now about Shadow Pokemon. Oh, Crocodile's holding an item, a Mystic Water. I'll keep that on him. Where's the Shadow? See that heart gauge? That purple bar there? That bar is going to slowly go down as I battle with it. And once it gets down to the bottom, we have to go to a certain spot in the game, which hasn't been revealed to us yet. But we do that, and yeah, then it becomes a regular Pokemon. But I'm going to go back and heal, then I'll come right back to this spot. Alright, I've healed, and we're leaving town, although I completely forgot where we were told we're supposed to go, but I'm guessing I'm going here, because that's the next spot. It's a construction lot. Alright. Ooh, wow. That's fancy. This is a construction site, not a safe place to be. There's no place for tourists to visit. Go on, scram. Who? Well, just for saying that, we're gonna stay. We're rebels. Oh, so they're done constructing. They just have to clean up. Oh, okay. Oh, I've been working hard, I have. Alright, anyone else over here? No. Alright, let's see what's in this door. It's locked. Maybe I'm just supposed to go here and realize it's closed and then leave? Yay, that's what I was supposed to do. Pyrite Town. This, I think, is the main town of the game. Or at least it's the... maybe not. I remember it as that, but I might be wrong. And I used the theme of this song in the Aquablade Chronicles as, John Fenton, the evil Fenton brother's theme. Keep telling me I don't know anything. This better be true, Kale, if you're done. So, he's questioning him, and he thinks he's lying. That looks like a police officer, I think. What a nitwit. Of course I haven't got a thing to tell you. Wow, so obviously he does have something we should learn. Yeah, tourists. Well, let's go with that. How about this old guy? Does he have anything to say? The town of Earth, Wind, and Money? Wow. Those are interesting elements. Wind, Earth, and Money. Alright. We're Mirror B's recruits? Yeah, sure. Like, I want to work for that guy. Then again, that might be pretty cool. Your outfit's kind of weird, but you're a trainer. Yes, I'm a trainer. Oh. Alright, so... in this town, you just fight people when you say hello. Sentret and Talo. What is this? Let's use the weakest Pokemon of a certain generation? I'm just kidding. Sentret, I think, is the weakest of the second generation. And Talo is... well... oh, and Shadow Pokemon, all they know is Shadow Rush, which is basically like Struggle. It does very low damage and it does recoil, so... I don't know how it knew Surf in that one battle, but... yeah, it only knows Shadow Rush, and then it learns other moves, and then, yeah. Let's go for Sentret first. And I have Espeon instead of Umbreon because he is, let's be honest, stronger, and he's a lower level, so... that was a critical... oh, wow, that did a lot. It wouldn't have done that much if it wasn't a critical hit. Wow! Goodbye, Sentret. Oh, and Shadow Pokemon do not gain experience. They do not gain experience at all. And they sometimes go into hyper mode. Which means you can either choose to attack them, choose to use them to attack, or choose to not. When they're in hyper mode, they have a much higher chance of a critical hit, but they also have a chance of not listening to you. At least that's what I remember. But if you click this button, call, they get out of hyper mode, but unfortunately, it uses up their turn. But I do not want them in hyper mode, so let's go for Talos. Lukoth can only attack once per turn. I mean, once every other turn. So, yay! And look how much of the shadow bar that made go down. So basically, getting them out of hyper mode is a good way to make them turn into a regular Pokemon quickly. But if you're in like a really tight situation, you might want to keep them in hyper mode because they're slightly stronger. So, it's a give and take. Personally, I'd rather get him to regular Pokemon as quick as possible so he can actually get experience. And he learns special defense, which sucks because Return is a physical attack, but Espeon has crap physical attack. Why not? What's the worst that'll happen? He's not even going to be able to attack this turn anyway, Slakoth, because... And that did nothing. Because Slakoth has... Oh my god, he's in hyper mode again! Oh my god. This better not happen during boss battles. I hope he's getting it all out of the way now, so we don't have to worry about it later. And I'm trying confusion now. Let's see how much this would have done if I had used it before. It did about the same, so it wouldn't have mattered. And what's he gonna do now? Wow! Oh, and Carter, and he learned Scary Face! See, he slowly gets his old moves back, and once he's a regular Pokemon, Shadow Rush is replaced with his final move. At least that's what I remember. And... Wow, Krogon, you didn't do anything that battle! But, that's okay, I understand, you do not have a heart right now, you're basically a heartless. That's okay. Whoops, you were better than me! Yeah, whoops! That's what you get when you bring crappy Pokemon. You tripped yourself up. Foo 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 foo. Who laughs like foo foo foo? Is it supposed to be like fa-fa-fa-fa-fa-fa? Still, I don't know anyone who laughs like, unless it, yeah. Where's a place to heal? Is this a Pokemon Center? There's a Pokeball on it. But I could have sworn I said there aren't any Pokemon Centers. Ew. Looks like some guy's office. Let's talk to him. Duking, he was the owner of the Colosseum. And he's busy. Alright, how about this little person? You're the lookout. Really? Really? Are you serious? Oh my god. Okay. How did you get in here? That's weird. This was the lookout. He's the worst lookout I've ever seen in my life. I guess he is just a little kid and doesn't know, but that's okay. You want to play house. Wow, okay. I kinda just met your papa, but... What are they playing? Are they playing a drinking game? There's all these bottles on it, and they're little kids. Oh my god. That's just wrong. Okay. Uh-oh. How much are you gonna take from Mirror B and his stooges? They're using you and the color. Uh-oh. That guy's working with Mirror B. Did they suck the spirit right out of you? Dot dot dot. So you just clam up. I've lost faith in you. So interesting. Somehow Duking is with Mirror B. The man that went out is Silva. He's Duking's friend. He was really angry. His face looked all scary. Ha 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 ha. And Krogon just learned Scary Face. He's still super busy. Alright, so we've learned one thing. That Mirror B is using the Colosseum for something. I don't know what. We're coming up to, like, about almost 15 minutes now, so we'll do a couple more battles. Uh-oh. Yes, we hear that in this square that I saw that strange Pokemon. I tried to leave town afterwards, and that's where those creeps grabbed me. We should be careful. There's nothing normal about this town. What town in the world is normal? Oh, yeah, I think if you talk to any of these people, they'll battle you. So let's battle a couple, just to get some experience. Would you like to battle with me? Hey, why not? Oh, and I just realized you can heal in the Colosseum. It's across the bridge to the north. So after this battle, I'll probably heal, then do another one and see where. Oh my god! Evolved Pokemon? Well, it Noctowl's evolved, Letty Bison'd. Oh my god. I was not expecting that. Uh-oh. Oh, and Noctowl's a shadow Pokemon. I could catch Noctowl if I want, but I don't, because Noctowl sucks a lot. But, and he's level 30, so he's going to be kind of tough, so let's try to kill him. Actually, Espeon, use Reflect, because I'm scared. There, now we've raised our defense. Oh, you son of a... Oh, you... Well, you know, is Shadow Rush considered a physical or a special move? Judging by that damage, I'm guessing it's a physical move. Either that or Croconaw just sucks. Oh. And by using... Clearly, this guy's strategy is using defensive moves. I have no issue with that. But that's okay. His Reflect does not stop Espeon because Espeon's a special attacker. Never mind. It still sucked. A lot. Ha 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 ha. Oh, you son. Oh my. Is he serious? Is this guy letting me win? Because that's not fair. Oh well. Gives Croconaw some time to get out of his shadow state. And yeah. Oh my god, this is gonna take a while. Is this guy serious? He's just gonna keep using Reflect and Safeguard? Does this guy know anything about battling? Clearly not. You know, you usually have to, like, attack the other person, you know, to try to, you know, win. Finally! Ow! Alright, hit with recoil. Good. Now, Croconaw, you should be able to kill him. Critical hit. That's okay. Bye, Noctowl. I did not want to catch you. Because Noctowl sucks a lot. And I know some people would disagree, but I'm sorry. He does. He's one of the worst flying Pokemon there is. Comet Punch. I have a feeling Espeon's gonna die. Oh, wait! He went for Croconaw. Never mind. Alright, Crocky. Since Ledyba just wants to use Safeguard, I don't see it as a threat. Let's just go for Wingull. Wingull's a pretty good Pokemon. I mean, for a first evolution, I guess you could say. Oh, wow. I stand corrected. Ah, so close to the next level. And nice damage. And Comet Punch again. Alright. I think even if that hits five times, I won't die. Yep, I was right. Haha. Oh, wait, our Reflect. Oh, wait, I forgot I had a Reflect up. That's why I was doing such crap damage. I forgot I had raised my own Reflect. And their Safeguard also faded. You'd think if you use Safeguard more than once, it would, like, replenish it. I think they should add that in when they make the next Pokemon generation. Moves like Reflect, Light Screen, Safeguard, things that last for a certain amount of turns, I think if you use it again, it should just replenish the five turns or however long it's kept active, instead of being it fails. You know what I mean? But that might change. That people might disagree with that, but I think they should. I mean, I think it should be in the next game, because... But I guess the reason they don't is because they want at least one turn where it's not active, so... Okay. It attacks more likely critical hits. Why did Trainer Sheriff Strange Pokemon? I'm sure of it now, that town's hiding a big secret. Uh-oh. Town's hiding a big secret. I wonder what that secret might be. Oh, and I think you can fight those trainers in the square more than once. So if I did want to come get that Noctowl, I could. But... Yeah. Let's go in here, because I know there's a healing spot. See, there's a little machine here. That's what we're going to find from now on. We're not going to find actual Pokemon centers. And this video, I think, has been long enough, so we will fight the rest of those trainers in the square, or maybe not, in the next part. And I will save it at this computer right now. See you all next time. I hope you enjoyed this, and rock on.